It has been a hectic last 24 hours of news in the NRL with the announcement that Reece Walsh will indeed not go back to New Zealand. Now, a lot of us sort of expected this. Even when Walsh came out at the start of the season and committed himself to New Zealand, however, we all thought he was going to go to the Dolphins as their marquee signing. But instead, he has signed with the Brisbane Broncos on a 3-year deal. Now, there are mixed reports whether it's $1 million a season or the contract is worth $1 million. For the sake of this video, I will try to cover both. However, I do believe it is more likely that the deal is worth $1 million across the 3 years rather than $1 million a season, because that would be massive overs. However, either way, I do believe that this signing could really hurt the Broncos long term, and I think the Warriors won this deal with the signing of Charles Nickel Klokstad. I hope you guys will hear me out, especially the Broncos fans who are already rinsing me in that comment section. But guys, before we get any more into the video, over 90% of you watching this are not subscribed, so please smash that subscribe button. It is completely free and you can always change your mind later. Also, smash that like button if you do go on to enjoy this video, and leave a comment down below about your thoughts on these signings and whether I am right or am I wrong. Now, first things first, I think Reece Walsh is one of the best young talents we have seen in the NRL for a long time. And for those who do watch my videos, you guys know how much I love Reece Walsh. But that does not change the fact that I think that this signing could go horribly wrong for the Brisbane Broncos. But before we get knee deep into that discussion, I just want to quickly talk about Charles Nickel Klokstad going to the New Zealand Warriors, also on a 3-year deal. Now, I don't know how much he is signing on for, but I would assume that it's around maximum 600 to 700k. But even on that, I still think this was a great decision by the Warriors to sign Charnsy. Now, from what I've been told, Charles decided to leave the Raiders to go back to New Zealand for family reasons, similar to why Walsh is going back to Queensland. We all knew that Walsh was never going to be committing to the Warriors long term. Even if he did stay in 2023, I think we all assumed that he would be back in Queensland by 2024. So, for the Warriors to be able to get Nickel Klokstad in long term, when they probably knew they were going to lose Walsh at some point, was a brilliant decision by the Warriors. Unfortunately, the Warriors are not known for making the smartest moves, but this definitely was smart, and you could argue that is actually an upgrade. Now, does Walsh have a higher ceiling than Charles Nickel Klokstad? In my opinion, absolutely. But when we're talking about the best players, or at least who's better than who, you have to look at their body of work. And when you do that, it's hard to argue that at the moment, Charles isn't the better fullback than Reece Walsh. Now, has Walsh been better on form for the past 2 seasons? Well, yes, because unfortunately, ever since 2021, Charnsy has dealt with a few injuries, but there is a very logical, so vital in the Raiders' premiership chances in both 2019 and 2020, and was the best player in that 2019 grand final until he got subbed off. The Raiders only fell off last year once Charnsy got injured, and unfortunately, the man has had to deal with injuries again this year. But it's probably better to say that Charnsy's 2019 and 2020 seasons were in fact better than Reece Walsh was last year, even though it was Walsh's rookie year. Charnsy is only 26, so to get a player that you could argue is better than Walsh and that can commit to your club long term was a great decision by the Warriors, and I do think the Warriors are the best party to come out of this deal. But for the Raiders, real quick, we'll just quickly hop onto them. I do think that it's a big loss, but it's sort of a similar situation. The Raiders obviously have high hopes for Xavier Samage, who they've already prioritized and will continue to prioritize his development, And if there is an injury, they have Rapana to cover it. So while it is a loss for the Raiders, I don't think it's going to hurt them too much long term, because they do have Xavier Savage, who is going to be their number one choice going long term anyway. Now, the Broncos fans have already disliked the video and called me an idiot, which you would be correct in saying, I guess, but please just hear me out. In the short term, this signing will definitely benefit the club more then it would hurt it because you have Reece Walsh. The problem is going to come, in my opinion, in about 12 to 18 months when I think the Broncos are going to have to pick between Selwyn Cobbo and Reece Walsh. As well as that, I think that Herbie Farnworth and guys like Billy Walters, Corey Oates could be gone sooner rather than later as well because of this signing. From what we have been told and what we have seen this year, Cobbo is out and out the closest thing we have seen to Latrell or GI. And I don't think it's crazy to say that at 20 years of age, Cobbo is better than Latrell was at 20 years of age. We have been told over and over again that Cobbo will take over the fullback position at the Broncos for the next 10 years at least. But now, you have to ask the question, because of this Reece Walsh signing, what happens to Cobbo? I think that in 2023, this signing won't be an issue. I think that it'll definitely benefit the Broncos more than it will hurt them. We'll most likely see Cobbo stay on one wing, with Walsh moving to fullback. But going forward, do Broncos fans really believe they can hold on to them both? Especially when the Dolphins are sniffing around, still without their marquee signing, and then when the Broncos just re-signed Cobbo, I would be 90% certain that they promised him to play fullback. Obviously, I can't speak for Selwyn, but I don't think he's going to want to stay on an edge when Wayne Bennett could be promising him a massive upgrade, the starting fullback position, and being the face of a new franchise. Now, maybe the Broncos do see this as a short-term move, with Cobbo moving back to fullback long-term, but if Walsh is signed on $1 million a season, then you have just ruined your salary cap. You're not going to be able to re-sign Farnworth, especially if there's no room in your backline. Oates is off contract soon, Billy Walters is off contract for next year, and they've still got the whole Payne Haas saga to deal with. So if they have signed Walsh on big money, I think that Payne Haas is about 99% gone at the end of the season. Either way, I don't think it's a move that makes sense to sign Walsh on big money, even if it's not $1 million, even if it's around like $600K to $700K. You will have to sacrifice some players, but it also could really hurt Cobbo's development at fullback. And it's not like the Broncos are in a win-now scenario. Otherwise, you don't get Reece Walsh, who is only a rookie, and you are probably better off getting a Charles Nicol-Klocksack because he knows what it takes to go deep into the finals. And he nearly won a premiership with the Raiders. A 6-again call and him going off the field could have pretty much cost the Raiders that 2019 premiership. But look, either way, I do think that while this signing will benefit the Broncos in the short term, it can create a lot of headaches in the long term. And if the Broncos don't handle this correctly, then it could go horribly wrong. If I was a betting man, I would have to say that either Walsh, Cobbo, and even some of the other boys will end up at the Dolphins. Now, obviously, does this mean that the Broncos will fall back to 16th and the Dolphins will win the comp? I really highly doubt that. But after only half a season of success, after some real rotten years, I do fear for the Broncos. But just like everything, we give our opinions, but at the end of the day, I guess we'll just have to wait and see. Guys, thank you so much for watching. If you did enjoy this video, then please smash that like button. If you're new here and you love your footy, then please smash that subscribe button. We are so close to 3,000. I would love every single one of you to be a part of it. It's completely free to subscribe. This ain't Twitch, baby. This is the Tube. And obviously, comment your thoughts about my video down below and your thoughts on Charnsey going to the Warriors and Walshy going to the Broncos.